Why does blood sugar rise without eating? One of the diabetics I've walked this road with got discouraged at the start because fasting caused her blood glucose to rise, and she quit. Why the heck does this happen? Stick with me until the end, and I'll tell you what happened to my friend. I'm Jackie from reversingdiabetes.life, here to explain why your blood glucose can rise when you're not even eating. And any other questions about my journey from fat, weak, and sick to trim, strong, and healthy, leave your question in a comment so I'll know what videos to make next. So we're in for a bit of a biochemistry lesson here, and I realize that doesn't thrill anyone, so I'm going to play with some Legos as we go. First, we have to understand a few basic facts about biochemistry and about Legos. One of the main fuel sources for your cells is glucose, the symbol sugar. In a normal body, when we have more glucose than we need, it is stored in short-term storage. A bunch of glucose molecules get stuck together to make a molecule called glycogen. Glycogen is like a Lego structure. It's what we call a polymer, which basically means it's made out of a bunch of littler pieces that are all identical, unlike these Legos, which are obviously different. It's a bunch of little pieces stuck together, so they can be taken apart rapidly. Most of this is stored in the liver, but some is stored in the muscles too. There's more details in the links in the description box for those who want to know more. So, glycogen is why we don't have to eat constantly. We have fuel stored. Otherwise, our cells would starve to death in our sleep every night. So this is a good system generally because, as it turns out, we need sleep. Okay, so glycogen storage happens in diabetics too. We have a bunch of glycogen stored because we've had more glucose than we needed in our blood for a long time. We store more and more and more until our glycogen is stuffed full, and then fat happens, but that's another topic for another video. So when we need glucose, we get something that many diabetics call a liver dump, which is when our livers take apart the Lego structure and spit the individual bits back into our bloodstream. So blood glucose goes up, and if we have a lot of glycogen stored, it can go up a lot. I can already hear you arguing with me. My blood glucose was already 150. Why the heck did it shoot up to almost 300? I didn't need any more glucose. Well, don't argue with me. Argue with your body. If your blood sugar has been high for a long time, that's what it considers enough. Yeah, your body is wrong, but we can fix that. So we have another biochemistry concept to discuss, homeostasis. The basic idea of homeostasis is like a body's thermostat. It keeps lots of things close to the same. Temperature, like any thermostat, but also other things, fluid balance, hormone levels, and blood glucose levels. Again, there's more details in the description box. So just like storing all that glucose as glycogen is a good strategy for people overall, though it sucks a bit for diabetics, homeostasis is a good strategy overall too. If your body could reply to you asking why it wants to keep your blood glucose the same, it might say, because it's worked so far. You're alive, aren't you? Basically, what fasting does for us is turning the thermostat down. Now, it might take a bit of time for your body to notice the new setting, but if you persist, you'll get there. Finally, you need to understand your liver is dumping sugar. Sure, it's dumping into your bloodstream and making your meter unhappy, but you are getting rid of sugar. This is a good thing. Getting rid of sugar is how you lower insulin, and that's how you fix insulin resistance. And that, my friend, is how you kick diabetes to the curb. At the start, I told you about my friend Jennifer. She got freaked out during her first fast when her blood glucose got really high and stopped cold. But once she understood what was happening, she got back on track and is persisting. And as her insulin resistance continues to improve, it takes less and less insulin to control her blood glucose. My diabetes is in remission. Yours can be too. If you have questions for me, you know what to do. Comment.